Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to do this retro vector graphic style grid landscape effect in HitFilm Express. So this actually was inspired by a request on the forums on how to do this in Pro, which I have done a tutorial a long time ago on how to do this in Pro, but then it got me thinking, hey, you know, I've never actually done this in Express, and it would be pretty easy to do, so here we are. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start by creating a new composite shot and click OK, and in that composite shot, I'm going to create a new plane, and I'm going to make that plane very large, like 5,000 by 5,000, and click OK. This will be our landscape. I'm just going to go ahead and make this into a 3D plane, and I have my HitFilm set up so that the camera is automatically added. If it does not automatically add, you will want to do that. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the floor planes. And then I will just take the plane itself and rename it. I'm going to rename it grid to start so that I know which one this is. I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees on its x-axis. And now if I take the camera and I lift it up a little bit, maybe 300, and I put a grid effect on the actual plane, then I will be able to see the plane, and it looks pretty good. I think I will tip this forward slightly, the camera, and then I can just bring this up so that it's sitting about there. As far as the grid effect is concerned, I want to go ahead and change the size. Maybe let's go negative 50 by negative 50 by 50 by 50. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty good. That way the grid itself is, you know, big enough that you can see it, but not too big. And let me just go ahead and keyframe the positions here. I'm just going to, you know, move forward, you know, a little bit, not a lot, you know, just enough so that, you know, it's sort of moving over the landscapes type of a thing. All right. What I need to do is I need to create a map that will delineate exactly how the landscape of the grid is undulating and things like that. So I'm going to create a new plane. This one I will leave as a normal plane. And I'll bring it down here. And to that plane, I'm going to put a fractal noise effect. And then that fractal noise effect, if I turn off the other one just for a moment, I just want to kind of tweak a little bit the appearance of it, the offset and the exposure, as well as the scale of it. And that will create, you know, that will kind of define the map of it itself. To do that, though, it would make it a lot easier if I could do that while I was able to see the grid. So I'm going to turn off that plane, and I will create a grade layer, which I will place over that plane. So that way, when I add the secret sauce, which is the parallax effect, to the grid plane, and I open it up, I can go ahead and source, as the height map, the grade layer. I'm going up the depth. And now I turn on the plane, you can see that there's some undulation there. There will be more after I add a light. So let's go ahead and add a new light. And this will light everything. And I want to lift that light up a little bit higher because it's not high enough to really light everything. Maybe 1500 or so. Yeah, okay, so you can sort of see that there are some undulation there, but we want to tweak the settings of the fractal noise, so let's just go through those. Under appearance, the exposure, if I start to take this down a little bit, then you can see that it's going to create bigger movement in it. And the offset, if I take it down a little bit, then you'll see that it'll create more of them. Okay. And also, if I change the transform properties, say I take the scale down, then it will give me even a tighter region here of that area. And you just sort of play with these until you feel like You know, this is not too far off the mark. And then when you have something, then, you know, all you have to do if you want to change the color of the grid, you can, you know, maybe make it green, or I think I'll make mine light blue today just because. And then when you're done, you have something that looks like this. So in a nutshell, that's pretty much how you do it. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments section below. And like and subscribe if you want more content like this. Otherwise, thanks for watching.